Everyone, in this video we have one special question. Okay. These two parts are equal and here is 3 alpha, here is 7 alpha, here is 4 alpha, and then theta is asked. Okay. First up, in this kind of special question we need to an isosceles or equilateral triangle. Therefore, I want to create an isosceles triangle. So, if we get here 3 alpha, we have an isosceles triangle, right? Okay. For this triangle, we know that sum of the interior angles equals 180 degrees. So theta plus 14 alpha equals 180 degrees. Okay. Notice that 7 alpha, this angle must be theta. And then this triangle is an isosceles triangle, therefore AK must be equal, let's call here C point, AK must be equal KC. Okay, so these two parts are equal. If you notice that, opposite of the thetas are same length, that means if we connect these two points, we get a cyclic quadrilateral. Opposite of the three alphas have same length as well. So if we draw circumcircle of this cyclic quadrilateral, if here is 7 alpha, this angle must be 7 alpha. And if here is 4 alpha, this angle must be 4 alpha. Because they have same arc. Okay. As a result, if you notice that, we get two congruent triangle. Because according to side angle side, these two triangle are congruent. That's right here. BAK triangle and DCK triangle are congruent. We know that congruent triangles have same angles and same length. That means this length, which is opposite of the 3 alpha, must be equal this length, which is opposite of the 3 alpha. Finally, we get an isosceles triangle. And then we know that sum of the interior angles equals 180 degrees. Therefore, 18 alpha equals 180 degrees. So alpha is going to be 10 degrees. But theta is asked. So theta plus 14 alpha equals 180 degrees. Therefore, theta equal 40 degrees. Thanks for watching. And if you want more videos like this, please subscribe my channel. Bye.